Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to iTouch App Reviewers. Today I've got another couple stories for you guys. Of course, they're a little different. They're not all Apple news, but I was thinking I might need a name for this series of videos where I just go over the news with you guys. So I'm thinking about that. If you have any ideas, drop them down below. But anyways, let's get on to the stories. First off here, contact info for millions of Instagram influencers, celebrities, and brand accounts were leaked online. Yet another example of why you should not have a Facebook, Instagram account, any of that crap. Facebook just cannot keep anything secure these days, it seems. But the database here, which was hosted on AWS, contains more than 49 million records, was accessible without a password or other credentials, according to the security researcher who informed TechCrunch about the leak. This included a profile picture, biography, follower numbers, and private contact information like phone numbers and email addresses. This was posted on a social media chatterbox, whatever that is, and they went through it and found several high profile influencers in the exposed database, including prominent food bloggers, celebrities, and other social media influencers. So this is a pretty bad look for Instagram there. Definitely not something that Facebook wanted. Again, they just cannot stay out of the news for different security issues. But next up here, let's talk about Tfue. If you guys don't know who Tfue is, I don't know what rock you've been living under, but he is suing FaZe over their contract. If you guys watch Juke Squad, you know that this is Jack Tenney's brother, Turner, and he is 21 years old. You guys probably know him as Tfue because he started playing Fortnite and, you know, was really good and winning all these contests and stuff, making a lot of money. No one knew about this guy before he signed with FaZe. As soon as he signed with FaZe, his numbers skyrocketed. Absolutely crazy how quickly he skyrocketed. But anyways, he was a pretty good player. Now he is suing FaZe because they were taking supposedly 80% of his money, which FaZe came out and said, nah, we did not take that much money. They claim they've only taken like 60 grand from him and he's made millions. So that's not very much money, honestly, in the grand scheme of things, especially for what they've done for him. I mean, they have made this guy who he is pretty much. So personally, right now, I am on FaZe's side here of this, but again, the facts need to come out first before anyone jumps to any conclusions. But here is the lawsuit. If you want to read it, it's right here. It's pretty long if you want to read all of the complaints and stuff. But anyways, let's move on to some Apple news here. Now, it's shitty Apple news, but it is Apple news. So Microsoft's Edge for Mac browser is now available in preview. So if you guys didn't know, Microsoft is completely switching up how they're doing web browsing. They're actually basing their new web browser on the Chromium browser. So Chromium is like the base bottom of the barrel build of a web browser that Chrome is built on. Now Chrome itself is completely built by Google and has a lot more features and tracking stuff built into it. Chromium has a little bit less. I believe it's still built by Google, but it's open source. So Microsoft took that Chromium and decided to make their own brand new browser that is coming later this year, I believe. So if you guys want to try it out for whatever reason, there it is. I don't recommend Chromium-based browsers just for privacy reasons. That's why I'm on Firefox here. I mean, even Safari is better in my opinion. But anyways, if you want to check it out, here you go. All right, lastly here, Mario Kart Tour beta test emails appear to be rolling out to lucky players. If you guys actually signed up for the open beta test applications, you may be actually getting these emails. And this is only for Android, in case you guys were wondering. I don't know why they're doing it like that, because usually iOS apps get way more publicity and way more downloads and money. If you are one of the lucky customers, I guess, you guys probably got notified, and there's emails reportedly asking those who have been successful to refrain from posting any images or videos of the game online. Obviously, not everyone's going to respect that, and they might actually post them anyway, but we'll have to see about that. But that's pretty cool. It's Android only right now, which is kind of disappointing, but we should see maybe some iOS stuff start to come out about this soon. I am definitely looking forward to this. So that's all I got in the news today for you guys. If you liked the video, hit it with a big thumbs up and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.